Hey YouTube, I've had a request to do a music collection video. Now 15 minutes isn't enough time to show you my entire music collection. So I gathered up just a sampling of CDs that it'll kind of give you an idea of my taste in music. So, let's get started. This first CD, and by the way, I don't buy CDs anymore. I don't know anyone that does buy CDs. I don't even know if CD stores are still in existence. But I stopped buying CDs a long, long time ago. I download my music these days, but it's kind of hard to get those nice ASMR quality sounds off of a download. So anyhow, this first one is a Charlie Daniels Band Decade of Hits. I've seen Charlie Daniels in concert before. He put on a good show. I guess my favorite song off of this CD would be Uneasy Rider. It's a pretty good, entertaining song. I also like Kenny Loggins. This one is Outside from the Redwoods. One song in particular that I like of Kenny Loggins is Celebrate Me Home. That one never gets old. I love that song. And then there's Stevie Nicks. A lot of people don't know that her full name is Stephanie Lynn Nicks. And she was with Fleetwood Mac, and she's one of my favorite female vocalists. I don't know how old she is these days, probably in her 60s, but she was great. Elton John's songwriter Bernie Taupin actually wrote a song for Stevie called These Dreams. Stevie graciously declined to record it. He passed it along to Ann and Nancy Wilson of Heart. And there it became Heart's first number one hit. Maybe Stevie should have kept it. I listen to a lot of types of music. Classical being one of those. And Mozart is hard to beat. Everybody's heard of the Eagles. Historically, they've had great music back in the day, but their albums always had poor quality artwork, in my opinion. A lot of good songs on this CD. Take It Easy, Lying Eyes, Desperado, a lot of good stuff. Peaceful, Easy Feeling. And here's another Eagles CD, and once again, poor quality artwork. I like Billy Joel. He's got a lot of good stuff. A lot of good stuff. Oh yeah. Junior Walker and the All-Stars. Shotgun. Moody Jr. Shake and Flinger Pop. Pretty good stuff. Frank Sinatra. Old Blue Eyes. If you're not into listening to this kind of music, maybe you just need to give it a chance. Here's a CD with a lot of music on it from the 60s. Paul Revere and the Raiders. Blood, Sweat, and Tears. The Birds. Just to name a few. Roy Orbison. A lot of people don't know it, but Roy Orbison's voice had the same range as the famous opera singer Enrico Caruso. Orbison could hit high E above high C. That doesn't make sense. He could hit E above high C. And that just happens to be the peak that Caruso was famous for. Is that climb in his voice that became, I guess you could say, Orbison's trademark. Here's some Bach. Johann Sebastian Bach. You know, out of all the great composers, Bach may actually be the one that is remembered the longest, because NASA put 3 of his pieces on that the gold record that they put on the Voyager 1 and the Voyager 2 spacecraft. Now those spacecraft left our solar system some time back. And maybe if there's life out there, it'll find it, man. Give it a spin. Listen to some Bach. Here's some Steely Dan. This album, Asia. I know the title of the title song off this won a Grammy. There's a lot of other good stuff on here too. A Black Cow, Deacon Blues, Peg, Josie. I like to listen to this CD. It sounds pretty good on my speakers. My speakers have carbon fiber woofers, and the bass is just incredible. So I like to listen to that particular CD a lot. Here's a CD of Stevie Wonder. And most of these songs are from the early 70s. I guess one of my favorites off this CD would be track number 3, Living for the City, and number 5, Higher Ground. Stevie Wonder's one of the greats. The Doobie Brothers. Best of the Doobies. Right off the bat, I see China Grove. A lot of times when I take a road trip, one of the songs I like to put on early in the trip is China Grove. It just has that beat, that rhythm. It's just got that right sound to kind of get you in the mood for traveling. But my favorite off of this CD would be track number 9, South City Midnight Lady. I like that a lot. And I'm running out of time, so I better pick up the pace. Now this is what artwork should look like. This is off of, this is Journey, Greatest Hits. A lot of good stuff on this CD. Probably my favorite off of here would be track number 10, Lights. Here's some big band music featuring Duke Ellington and Glenn Miller. It's pretty good stuff. Johann Strauss. Some more classical music. Charlie Parker. Now, Charlie Parker was a saxophonist back in the 40s and 50s. And he had this kind of this bebop sound that kind of revolutionized jazz. Basically, it caused a jazz revolution. I've got this set. I think it pretty much has most everything he's done in it. Charlie Parker. Here's some Natalie Cole. She's the daughter of a Nat King Cole. Stardust was a good album. If you haven't checked out Natalie Cole, go on iTunes and do a sampling on Ahmad's Blues. Ahmad. I don't know who he is, but it's a great song. Some Boz Scaggs. Here's a little bit of Huey Lewis and the News. I've met Huey Lewis before. He's actually met him backstage after a concert. He's seemed like a pretty great guy. Pretty funny. Some pretty good music. And yes, Boston. It's a debut album of Boston. This guy here, he's the brains of the outfit, Tom Scholz. He graduated MIT. Got a job at Polaroid. In his spare time, he designed and built his own 12-channel mixer and started recording his own music. It's a really nice guitar sounds. It's awesome. Soundtrack from Apollo 13's got a lot of great music on it from the 60s. One of my favorite movies, Contact. Some great classical music on this. Glenn Miller. He led an orchestra. Glenn played the trombone. At the peak of his career in 1938, he joined the military to help with the war effort. In 1942, I think, his plane went down over the English Channel. They never did find his body. And some Supertramp. Very hard-driving music. Very nice. Sounds good. I've got to let this video go. I'm at the end of my time. Thanks.